Welcome to Vlogmas Day 6. Thank you for tuning in. If you've been tuning in every day, thank you so much. It means the world to me. If you want to like, comment, and subscribe, that would be great. It really helps out my channel. And then you can also turn on the notifications so you don't miss any of my Vlogmas videos. We're going to be doing a get ready with me, and we're just going to chat about the holidays, mental health during the holidays. This is the look that we're going to be creating right here. So this is with the Naked Heat palette, and I'm very excited. So I have the Naked Heat palette. I think my sister gave this to me as a Christmas gift. I think it was either my sister or my mom a few years ago. And the colors are just so like Christmassy without being like too Christmas, you know what I mean? They're just like kind of Christmassy just because they're super warm and like golden and smoky and ambery. So I feel like it's fun to kind of create like a smoky heat look. Obviously this year has been really interesting, and because of that I have been like so looking forward to Christmas and the holidays. And now with it being so close to Christmas, I just think it's so important for us to like really enjoy the holidays. And I think a huge thing of that is being in check with our mental health. This year 2020, like, honestly, I don't think you even need to say anything else. Like, it's just 2020. And this year for me has been hard. Like, I've had a lot of things happen. Just so much going on. But it's also been a good year in the sense that I've had to, like, actually work through things. And I got connected with a superb therapist, and I literally just cannot recommend therapy enough for people. And going into the holidays, like, yeah, it's a great time of year. It's my favorite time of year. It's usually, you know, spend time with your loved ones. And unfortunately, sometimes our family takes a toll on our mental health, and I think that's like normal for most people. Obviously, the people that you're closest to can hurt you the most, and the people that you're closest to have like the deeper penetrating power of the words they say carry a lot of weight. Their actions feel extra bad when they are not nice, just because it is family. And so going into the holidays, I just kind of wanted to talk about that a little bit and let you know, like, if you're nervous to see your family at the holidays and you're scared of what they're gonna say, or if they're going to make you feel like crap, or if maybe just being around them just doesn't make you feel good, like, that's okay. And something I've had to realize is that you get to determine like the power that someone has over you. So if you have a particular family member who's just, you know, maybe not very nice person to you, then just limit your time with that person, and that's totally okay. And if that means, you know, I'm not going to be over at this family member's house for like 7 days straight, I think 2020 has really shown us like who is important in our lives and who like should have a place in our lives, because we've been shown that life is short, things can happen, all your plans can go to complete wreckage at like a moment's notice. And so honestly, like, you need to decide what will make Christmas great for you. I'm just so excited for the holidays because I've just really come to accept like a lot of things, and like I've also had to accept that my mental health is up to me, and that's something I wanted to talk about as well. So you need to learn, like, what are the things that make it difficult for you to be happy? What are your triggers per se? Like, what are the things that you shouldn't allow into your life? Because unfortunately, a lot of people have a lot more stress around the holidays than happiness because they allow certain things in their life. And I'm not saying that it's your fault if there's like a toxic situation or person, but at the end of the day, it's up to you. And if that means that you need to find like a third party, like a therapist or a counselor, or just even an accountability partner who can help you evaluate what you should and should not allow in your life, that is going to be the key to good mental health this holiday season. I just want to communicate to you guys that like you should never feel bad for taking care of yourself and for like seeking help. And it's no matter what kind of help you need, whether that's just a therapist or just a friend's shoulder to cry on, or if it's depression meds or anxiety meds, like you should never feel bad about that. Keeping on that topic, a big thing I've been thinking about the last few months is self-care, and that subject in some circles I've been in has been very taboo. Like, we already care about ourselves so much, like why would we devote specific times to self-care? And I've come to realize that ideology really comes from like a misunderstanding of what I think most people mean when they're talking about self-care, or at least the proper meaning of what it should be. So for me, self-care has really become something where I look at like, what do I need so that I'm able to be the best version of myself, that I am able to like do things for other people and create content and be like a productive member of society that actually contributes to the world in a positive way. And to me, that's what self-care is. It's doing, you know, those steps, taking care of yourself so that you're able to work on what's important and you're able to make a difference. So for me, some of my favorite things with self-care, and I want to hear what you guys love to do for self-care, like what you do when you're feeling stressed out, what you do when you just need to like recenter yourself. I would love to hear about that. This year have been journaling a lot more in like the last like 2 months, and it's something I want to continue to do in 2021 and get even more like serious about, because I have found it to be so helpful. There have been a few situations that have come up since I started journaling where I was able to journal about my feelings and kind of figure out like why I was so upset or like what was actually wrong and bothering me, so that I was kind of able to work through it. Because if you're anything like me, I tend to bottle things up and I'll just hold on to these feelings of sadness and bitterness and hurt and never talk about it and never address it. Then I can basically just write whatever I'm feeling and I don't have to talk to anyone. I don't have to be afraid of what I'm saying, if it's gonna hurt someone's feelings or if it's gonna make me look bad, because the journal is just for me. That being said, that has been probably my top form of self-care. I think a lot of times people are like, oh, self-care, like face mask, hair mask, bathtub, like bath bombs in the bathtub and stuff like that. But I really think if you're gonna do like proper self-care and really like help yourself be recentered, it needs to be something deeper, like journaling or meditation. Another form of self-care per se that really goes along with the holidays is limiting your time with certain people. Unfortunately, some people who are in our lives who we do love and care about, and even friends and family, can sometimes be overwhelming or stressful. And so some of the self-care I've been putting into practice is being careful who I'm spending time with and how much time I'm spending with them. But we're gonna move on to the eyeshadow look. So I am gonna be trying to follow this little like Pinterest guide. So it looks like the first thing we do is add this transition shade, Sauced, like a transition color. So we're gonna go for that and see how it goes. So I used to really be into makeup, kind of like a side note. When I was like 13 and 14, I was like doing makeup tutorials, you know, for my YouTube channel and whatever. And with my depression, we're talking about mental health, that became something that kind of went to the wayside because I just never had the energy to like put time into my makeup. And I also really struggled a lot, and I still do, with like low self-esteem and feeling like I'm not worth the time or the energy for makeup, which is very sad. So if you feel that way, I'm so sorry, and I just hope you know that you are always worth the time and energy. I was so into makeup, like I had so much makeup, and now that I'm getting back into it, I throughout the years have had to throw a lot of things away because I didn't use it and it expired. So I'm slowly in 2021 going to be rebuilding my makeup collection again so that I can do more fun looks and different looks, because I really miss doing that. So if that's something you would like to see more on this channel, please let me know. Okay, so it looks like the second step is to take the shade of this one here, and this one is going just right into the crease, it looks like. So I'm gonna use this brush here. It's a little bit smaller than the one I was just using, so it's a little more pointed. And here we go. So this one is like doing it really pointed, a little more than I want. So I'm gonna go back to the bigger brush and just focus it. Doing it a lot darker on the inside, which is something that's kind of out of my comfort zone because I never really do that, but I'm going to try to stick to the picture. So I got to add a little bit more on the more towards the inner side of my eye. So now I'm going to take the more pointed brush, and it looks like we go in with the shade En Fuego. This really pretty like mule color. Mule? Is that a color? What am I thinking of? Mauve maybe is what I'm thinking of. Mulled wine is what I was saying. That was weird. I think I want it even darker. Like, I want this to look dramatic. Okay, so the next step is to take the shade Lumbre. This one here, sparkly one. And this one is gonna go all over the lid, it looks like. The next step is to add a little bit of this dark color ashes just in the outer corner with like a smaller brush here in case I didn't show you. And that's just gonna go like in the outer V, it looks like. I kind of like stopped talking about mental health, but I had to focus. Okay, so next in this look, they just had like a really nice winged liner. So I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna do it off camera because it makes me nervous for you guys to watch me. Okay, so the eyeliner is done. It's not perfectly symmetrical, but it's good enough for me. Now all we have to do is lashes. I have these magnetic lashes that I'm gonna use. But before I do that, I'm just gonna put a small coat of mascara on. Okay, so I do have to put on 3 coats of the Pro Magnetic liner or lash adhesive. So I'm gonna do that and then I'll be back and we'll put on the lashes. Okay, so we've got the 3 layers of the magnetic lash liner on. So now we're going to go in with the lashes. They have been a little tricky to put on, but I hope that this time will work really well. The reason I find them tricky is because I can't really use tweezers because they stick to the tweezers because they're magnetic. All right, so here we go, try the other one. All right, so there it is with the lashes on. These lashes do feel a little bulky. That is just one of the things, but it could just be because I'm not used to wearing them. But I also think it could be due to the actual magnets on the lashes, so they just feel heavier than normal lashes. Last thing we've got is lipstick, and I honestly don't know what to do. I wish this was live so I could ask you guys what to do, because I have this option, which is a Morphe Vanity Liquid Lipstick, which is basically like a nude because it's like the same color as my lips, which I think is the route I'm gonna go. But I also have this lipstick in like this dark purple, but I don't think I'm feeling that, so I think we're not gonna do that. And then the only other option is this one, which is like more of a nude. I think this is Birthday Suit from Tarte. This one's like a little darker, I think. I don't know. I think we're just gonna go with my tried and true Morphe. This dry for a minute and then I'm going to follow it up with my sexy mother pucker lip gloss. Ready? Mm-hmm. Also, this smells like chocolate. Highly recommend. I want like gloss on gold. The look is complete. Let me know what you guys think down below if you want me to do more makeup videos, because I think that would be really fun. I enjoy doing them. And like I said, it just makes me feel more like myself when I'm doing makeup and I'm getting back into it. So that makes me really, really happy. So thank you guys so much for watching. I am just so excited. I really hope you're enjoying the Vlogmas content. If you are, please let me know by liking and commenting. It would mean the world to me. Thank you again so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.